Just how much data do you think that little wafer can hold, anyway?
More than they look like they'd hold, Smarty. Up to 2 megabytes.
Huh? 2 megabytes? In that?
Of course!
Top data storages ever. Data is measured in bytes, not to be confused with bits. 1 byte is 8 bits. Information is all around us. With technology advancing every day, humans are finding more ways to store and use ever-expanding information pool. Let's start with the 1/8 byte. Every piece of information on computers is coded with 2 numbers, 1 or 0. Everything including color data from pixels of images, code for operating systems and text and numbers for programs. 1 and 0 equals to 1/8 of a byte. Pair of DNA, 2 times more than 1 or 0. DNA is the code of life, so it makes sense that it can be measured in data. There are 4 base pairs for DNA. The millions of combinations determine the characteristics of an organism. Each base pair can be identified on a computer with 0001, 10 or 11. 1 base pair is 1/4 of a byte of a data. Binary code, 4 times more than base pair. Binary code is made of 1 and 0 in 8-digit long combinations. Today it is used in many things. It is used to encode information and commands for computers. It is also how sounds and video is stored on CDs, DVDs and Blu-ray discs. 1 string of binary code is 1 byte. RAM of Atari 2600, 128 times more than binary. RAM stands for Random Access Memory. It is present in computers, tablets and other electronics. It allows the device to randomly access any byte of data. The Atari 2600 is one of the oldest gaming consoles, introduced in 1977. It had 128 bytes of RAM. ENIAC, 1.6 times more than binary. Completed in 1945, the ENIAC was a 30-ton computer, originally made to calculate ballistic trajectories of mortar shells. The machine was made with $500,000, equivalent to $6 million today. It had 20 accumulators that could each store 10 digits, probably an equivalent to 200 bytes. Floppy disk, 7,200 times more than ENIAC. Younger generations probably aren't very familiar with these. Floppy disks used magnetism to store data, but before better storages were invented, floppy disks were commonly used for small files. Because of its size, it was used mostly for text files, or a few low-quality images. The floppy disk has a capacity of 1.4 megabytes. IBM's hard disk, 2.6 times more than floppy disk. In 1956, IBM released the first commercial hard drive, the IBM 350, for what it would cost almost $500,000 today. The drive had 50 12-inch radius disks, each which had 100 tracks. Hard disks today can have around 300,000 tracks on a disk with a 1-inch radius. These tracks go around the surface of the disk and contain data in 1 or 0. The IBM 350 could store 3.7 megabytes. Today this is barely enough storage for a single track of music. Works of Shakespeare, 1.4 times more than IBM. Anyone who had to do literature in high school is probably familiar with Shakespeare. His works include over 880,000 words. This is all the plays and poems he wrote through his career combined. His hard work equals to 5.2 megabytes of data. Compact disk, 134 times more than Shakespeare. Road trip, anyone? Maybe you remember bringing some of your favorite artists' CDs to make time pass for that 10-hour trip. Released in the early 80s, compact discs were a significant advancement in technology. These shiny discs are capable of holding 80 minutes of audio, or 700 megabytes. Entire human genome, 9.1 times more than compact disc. A genome is the genetic material of an organism. The human genome consists of 46 chromosomes. Each chromosome has millions of DNA base pairs, each one equal to 2 bits of data. In 2004, scientists completely sequenced the human genome, which totaled 6.4 gigabytes of data. Blu-ray discs, 7.8 more than human genome. Blu-ray discs are more advanced optical discs, with significantly more storage than CD and DVD counterparts. It achieves this by storing information with greater density. A dual-layer Blu-ray disc will have 50 GB of storage, microSD 20 times more than Blu-ray. SD cards are usually somewhere between 16 to 128 GB in size. One of the largest microSD cards today has a storage of 1 TB. However, most devices aren't compatible with such a large capacity SD card. Solid-state drive, 30 times more than microSD. Solid-state drives give faster read speeds than HDDs, but similar write speeds. Read and write speeds is how fast it can open and save data. One of the largest SSD has a storage of 30 TB. Human brain, 83 times more than solid-state drive. The human brain might be the most data-compact item on this list. The average person can recognize 5,000 different faces, capable of remembering stories, smells, and sights from years ago. Although scientists can't actually calculate how much storage the human brain has, some predictions indicate it could be up to 2.5 petabytes. Library of Congress, 4 times more than human brain. This is definitely not your average library. Located in Washington, D.C., the largest library in the world, has over 30 million books, 7 million manuscripts, and millions of recordings, photographs, and special items. As of 2005, it is estimated to have 10 petabytes worth of items, including non-book materials. This number is always increasing, as the library receives 15,000 items every day. Google, 1,500 times more than Library of Congress. As a company everyone has heard of and used, Google has the largest data centers in the world. In 2013, Randall Monroe estimated that Google company has 10 exabytes of data stored on disk and about 5 exabytes on tape backup, totaling 15 exabytes, which is 15 million terabytes. 6 years later, this number has gone up. Internet, 33 times more than Google. Technology is becoming more and more accessible to people from all regions. The amount of stored data continues to rise. In 2009, the internet probably had around 0.5 zettabytes, which is 500 million terabytes. This number is much bigger today. Universe, who the hell knows? The universe is constantly expanding. It should come to no surprise that this is the largest data size possible. However, measuring the size is an impossible task. Just think about every organism's genome, data on other planets, systems, and galaxies. Physicist Seth Lloyd estimated that the observable universe has 10 to 90 bits of data, which is this crazy amount of bytes. Still not as large as my meme folder.